Hello everyone, welcome back to Placement Buddies. So as promised in the last lecture, today in this lecture we are going to discuss about the control valves, right? So let us start. Control valve. So what is a control valve basically? Control valve is something which manipulates the flowing fluid, right? Or you can say it manipulates the flow of a fluid. So suppose a fluid is flowing, right? You need to stop the flow, or you can say you need to regulate the flow, you need to throttle the flow. Or suppose a fluid is not flowing, you can just open the control valve and make it flow, right? So these are the few purposes of using a control valve. It keeps the process variable as close as possible to the set point. So this is another advantage of control valve, you can say. What are the functions of a control valve? It is used to start and stop the flow, it is used to regulate the flow, it is used to prevent backflow, and it is used to release pressure. So after analyzing all these bullet points, we can derive a definition of control valve, which is: a valve is defined as any device by which the flow of a fluid may be started, stopped, or regulated by a movable part that opens or obstructs the passage. Okay, so since we are done with the definition, let me tell you what are the types of control valve, and we are going to discuss in detail about all the types of control valves, right? So the first type of control valve is a gate valve. This is the diagram of a gate valve. Please look at the laser pointer. So gate valves are some of the most common valves currently employed. Gate valves are used to start, stop flow, but are poorly suited for regulating or throttling the flow. So using a gate valve, you can basically start the flow of a fluid, you can stop it, but it is not recommended for throttling the flow, right? So these are the different parts of a gate valve: the yoke sleeve, the gland bush, the bonnet, disc, seat, gasket, packing gland, stem, and handwheel, right? So let us quickly go through the advantages. It is very simple in design, relatively cheap and easy to maintain. Very low pressure drop across the valve when the valve is in the fully open position. The replacement of gate valve disc is easy, right? It is a very important point, because easily the disc can get damaged at times, right? So you need a valve in which you can actually replace the disc easily. So gate valve is a good choice for this purpose. Replacement of seat rings, if fitted, is usually not a difficult task, so you can replace the seat rings as well, right? Now let us go through the disadvantages. Gate valves are not well suited for throttling, as it creates turbulent flow and frictional losses. As I already told you, it is not recommended for throttling. Now the reason is, it can create turbulent flow, and we all know that turbulent flow is not recommended in case of flow measurements, right? Now compared to a glove valve, a gate valve's seating surfaces are more difficult to refurbish. So we will go through glove valve as well. So when we will go through the glove valve, we will understand this point. Gate valve create turbulent flow when throttled and experience excessive vibration as a result. This situation should be avoided to prevent any damage to the internal parts. So again, the same thing, if you like, as I already told you, it is not recommended for throttling, but if you try throttling through a gate valve, it may create turbulent flow. Yeah, it creates turbulent flow, and because of turbulent flow, excessive vibration will happen, and there will be damage to the internal parts, right? So this is all I wanted to say about the gate valve. Now let us look at ball valve. Ball valves are rotary motion actuated valves. This type of valve is ideally suited for opening, closing applications, and can be used for low to very high flow rate systems. So as you can see, this is the diagram of a ball valve, and these are the different parts of a ball valve. It is fast acting, it flows in either direction, right? From point A to point B, as well as point B to point A. It seats very well and is not prone to leakage. It is well suited for direct local manual operation. It is cheapest of all the common valve types. This is a very important point and is usually asked in interviews. It is cheapest of all the common valve types, ball valve. It is having low manufacturing and low maintenance cost, and it is simple to design as well. But it is not suitable for throttling. Okay, it is suitable only for on-off operations, and it is rarely used in high temperature system. So in high temperature system, the internal parts may get damaged. Okay, so the next valve types are swing check valve and plug valve. At first we will go through the swing check valve. So swing check valves allow flow only in one direction, but not both. Swing check valves are also referred to as clack, non-return, stop, check and one way valves, right? You can say clack valve, non-return valve, stop valve, check valve, one way valves as well. Swing check valves allow almost unobstructed flow through the valve with a correspondingly low pressure drop, right? So this is the diagram of a swing check valve, and these are the different parts of a swing check valve. You can see this is the disc, this is the seat, gasket, bonnet, and the body of the swing check valve, right? Now what are the advantages? Swing check valves allow almost unobstructed flow through the valve with a correspondingly low pressure drop. This has been discussed in the definition itself. Accessing the valve's internals is easy due to large bonnet. As you can see, this is a very large bonnet, right? So you can access the internals of the valve very easily. Swing check valves are ideal for low medium velocity flow applications. What are the disadvantages? Swing check valves are not well suitable for applications where pressure fluctuations often occur. Again, it is related to damaging the internals of the valve. So whenever there is a lot of pressure fluctuations, we do not usually recommend using swing check valve, right? Now, rapidly or constantly varying pressure fluctuations will lead to the valve opening and the closing frequently. This will lead to wear of the disc and seat. So as I already mentioned in the last point, if you try using a swing check valve in a situation where there is pressure fluctuation, okay, so what it will do is the valve will constantly open and close, right? So this situation is called chattering, and due to chattering it will lead to the wear and tear of disc and the seat of the valve, right? So we don't want to damage the internals of the valve, so we will not use a swing check valve in pressure fluctuating situation, right? Now let us proceed towards the plug valve. So plug valve is one of the most common valve designs employed today. The plug valve has a simple design, few parts, and it is easy to maintain. Like the gate valve, it is not well suited for throttling applications, but it is well suited for on-off operation, right? So this is the handle of the plug valve. It's the stem, disc, bonnet, body, and handle retaining nut, right? Let us go through the advantages. It can be used for multi-port applications, as example, three-way valves. Multi-port valves reduce the number of valves required within a system. Okay, so if we are using a three-way valves, then we may require very less number of valves in a system. It is fast acting, I mean a quarter turn valve, and low pressure drop when fully open. But again, it is not suitable for throttling applications and high temperature applications, and these are the disadvantages of it, right? So we are still searching for a valve which is suitable for throttling applications, right? Here it is, butterfly valve. So butterfly valves are fast acting rotary motion valves. This type of valve can be used to start, stop, and throttle, which is regulate the flow, right? Now compared to other common process control valves, the butterfly valve offers significant advantages concerning the weight and space savings. Okay, iska weight kam hota hai, space bhi isko use karne se save ho jata hai zyada, right? The butterfly valve has found widespread applications in many industries due to its low number of moving parts bahut hi kam hai, low maintenance cost bhi kam hai, and simple design. This type of valve is particularly well suited for high flow, low pressure systems. So you can see this is the diagram of a butterfly valve, and these are the different parts like stem, body, seat, cap packing, retaining ring, lower steam bearing, disc, upper steam bearing, packing stack, gland packing, and shaft. So the biggest advantage of a butterfly valve is it is well suited for throttling applications, and it does not create significant turbulent flow when partially opened or closed. So we were searching for a valve which could maintain throttling, right? So we found butterfly valve. Now let us go through other advantages of a butterfly valve. Butterfly valves are similar in design to ball valves, but are more suitable for larger applications as they are generally cheaper and weigh less, right? So ball valves were the kind of valves which could give us a like cost saving and space saving, but butterfly valves are even better than ball valves in this respect, okay? Butterfly valves are fast acting, and the stem only needs to be rotated 90 degrees in order to change the valve from fully open to fully closed position, right? So this is basically the stem, 90 degree rotation se fully open position se fully closed position pe chala jayega, and vice versa, right? The streamlined butterfly disc allows the flowing medium to pass over the disc without a large pressure drop or flow restriction occurring, okay? But having said that, butterfly valves are having certain disadvantages as well. Butterfly valves have a low pressure drop when fully open, but not as low as gate and ball valves. So pressure drop ki comparison mein, बटरफ्लाई वाल्व्स गेट वाल्व या बॉल वाल्व्स के साथ हार जाता है एंड वी कैन सी गेट वाल्व्स एंड बॉल वाल्व्स में लो प्रेशर ड्रॉप और थोड़ा लो है, बटरफ्लाई वाल्व्स में उतना लो है नहीं. नाउ बटरफ्लाई वाल्व्स आर जनरली नॉट मेंटेन इन सीटू, दे आर रिप्लेस्ड एंटायरली व्हेन ओवरहॉल्ड इन अ वर्कशॉप. पिग्स और इंस्पेक्शन डिवाइसेस कैन नॉट पास थ्रू एन ओपन बटरफ्लाई वाल्व, क्योंकि ये वाला जो ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन है उससे वो पिग या इंस्पेक्शन डिवाइस पास नहीं होगा. सो दीज आर द सर्टेन डिसएडवांटेजेस ऑफ अ बटरफ्लाई वाल्व. द नेक्स्ट सेट ऑफ वाल्व्स आर ग्लोव वाल्व एंड डायाफ्राम वाल्व, राइट. सो ग्लोव वाल्व्स ऑब्टेन देयर नेम ड्यू टू द शेप ऑफ द स्फेरिकल वाल्व बॉडी, बट दिस इज स्लाइटली डिसेप्टिव एज ग्लोव वाल्व्स आर नॉट द ओनली टाइप ऑफ वाल्व विद दिस बॉडी शेप, राइट. सो ग्लोव वाल्व का नाम कहाँ से बना, बॉडी शेप से बना, राइट. ऐसा नहीं है कि वो डिस्क के शेप से बना है. ग्लोव वाल्व्स आर सम ऑफ द मोस्ट कॉमन वाल्व्स करेंटली एम्प्लॉयड. दिस इज द डायग्राम ऑफ अ ग्लोव वाल्व एंड दीज आर द डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ अ ग्लोव वाल्व, राइट. लेट अस गो थ्रू द एडवांटेजेस. Now, due to circular shape of the disc and seat, uneven wear across the machined area is unusual. Uneven wear hota nahi hai machined area ke paas, right? Glow valves can be used for throttling as well, but the valve does not give a great degree of control due to the large circular shape of the disc. If fine flow adjustments are needed, the glow valve design is probably not the best option. Fine flow adjustments ke liye glow valve ko hum use karenge nahi. An angled glow valve has one less right angle turn than a straight glow valve. This leads to a lower pressure drop. So एंगल्ड ग्लोव वाल्व का थोड़ा एडवांटेज है स्ट्रेट ग्लोव वाल्व की कंपैरिजन. डिसएडवांटेजेस क्या है, ग्लोव वाल्व्स सफर फ्रॉम अ हाई प्रेशर ड्रॉप व्हेन द वाल्व इज थ्रॉटल्ड एंड दिस कैन लीड टू डैमेज ऑफ द वाल्व इंटरनल कंपोनेंट्स. फिर वही बात, जब थ्रॉटलिंग कराएंगे हम ग्लोव वाल्व के थ्रू तो हाई प्रेशर ड्रॉप के हाई प्रेशर ड्रॉप हमको देखने को मिलेगा एंड एज अ रिजल्ट इंटरनल कंपोनेंट्स डैमेज हो सकते हैं. Glow valves are often jammed open due to incorrect operation. Incorrect operation की वजह से jam हो सकता है, right? Diaphragm valve, ये diaphragm valve का diagram है and these are the different parts of it. Now, what are the advantages? Polymer based construction materials make the valve well suited to corrosive environmental applications. इसका construction polymer based material से बना हुआ है diaphragm valve और इसके कारण corrosive environment applications में हम इसको आराम से use कर सकते हैं. Leakage is uncommon due to valves, few parts and low number of seals. Seals उतना ज़्यादा है नहीं, parts भी उतना ज़्यादा है नहीं, so leakage is not actually seen in case of diaphragm valve. Polymer based construction materials are less chemically reactive than their metal counterparts, right? The valve has a fast response time with reliable sealing. Now let us go through the disadvantages. Diaphragm valves are rarely suitable for high temperature applications as the polymer based materials are prone to cracking and embrittlement. High temperature में अगर हम एक diaphragm valve को expose करेंगे then जो polymer material है वो crack हो जाएगा या फिर embrittle हो जाएगा. So we will not expose it in a high temperature application, right? So diaphragm valves are also not recommended for high temperature applications. Okay? So as we are done with the different type of control valves, we have seen their advantages and disadvantages. Now let me tell you what is the selection criteria for control valves. एक control valve को select करने का क्या क्या criteria हो सकता है. Before selecting a control valve, we will see what is the type of fluid which will be passing through that valve, right? We will also look into the temperature, viscosity, specific gravity, etc. and other parameters of the fluid. We will consider the flow capacity of the valve. We will consider the inlet and outlet pressure. We will calculate the valve size and we will see the valve body construction as well, right? So this is all about this particular lecture of control valves. In the next lecture I will tell you about the characteristics of control valve. There are three characteristics of control valve to be precise. I will tell you about cavitation and flashing. This is a major issue while dealing with control valves, and I will tell you about CV, valve coefficient. Okay, so that's it for today guys. Milte hain agle lecture pe.